the last video, we have seen how to do the re-enrollment process on IMS portal. And in this today's video, I am going to show you how we can do the enrollment process for the first year admitted students of academic year 2021-22. So without wasting time, let's see the process of enrollment for first year B-Pharmacy students. This is the login page of IMS portal. The link of this login page is given in the description. You can check it. In this login page, you have to click on student registration. Then click on here for the direct admission students. Here the instructions are given for filling up the online application form. These instructions, you have to read it carefully. The most important thing is your email ID and mobile number. Once you are entering your email ID and mobile number, it will not be changed further and it should be validated by sending the OTP. So candidates will get the username and password through the SMS and on your registered email ID. By using that username and password, you have to complete your registration process. After reading all these instructions, you have to click here in the checkbox that I hereby confirm that I have read all the instructions carefully, and you have to click in this checkbox and then click on proceed. Here you have to enter your first name, then enter your middle name, then last name, that is your surname. After that, you have to enter your mother's name. Select the gender, male, female, then enter your date of birth. You can select it from calendar or you can type it over here. Then enter your email ID. The correct email ID you have to enter over here. All the notifications you will receive on this email ID, so it should be correct. Then you have to enter your mobile number. Mobile number will be validated by sending the OTP. Then click on register. After completion of this successful registration, you will receive the username and password on your registered email ID and mobile number. By using that username and password, you have to complete your enrollment process. By using the username and password which is received on your registered mobile number, you have to log in again. Enter your username and password. After login, click on student profile, then fill student profile. Again click on fill form. Here you can see the different tabs are given, that is personal details, contact details, reservation details, qualification details, additional details, photo signature, admission details, and lastly there is a document upload. So one by one, step by step, we have to complete all these steps. On each and every page we have to click on save and continue. On this page you have to enter your full name. The things which are given by asterisk mark, that are mandatory, that you have to enter, then only your form will get proceed further. Here you have to enter your full name. Then select the blood group and click on save and continue. So this step number one is completed. Now the second step is contact detail. So here nationality candidate type is displayed automatically. The region you have to select as per your address. Either it may be urban or rural. Then type here your correspondence address. select the state, district, then select your tehsil as per your address, enter the name of city or village where you are residing. And lastly, enter your PIN code. Then again the permanent address is asked. So if your correspondence address and residing address is same, then you have to click over here, that is same as correspondence. And if it is a different, then you have to enter your permanent address separately. Then click on save and continue. So this second step is completed. Now third is your reservation details. Here in this reservation details, the religion is given Hindu. Constitutional category you have to select. Either it may be a general, SC, NT, VJNT. So as per your caste, you have to select your constitutional category. Select here your specific caste from which you belong. Then select either yes or no, you are having caste certificate or not. Then caste validity, either you are having or not. Then select the non-creamy layer, either you are having or not, that is yes or no. Then if you are having a non-creamy layer certificate, then mention here the non-creamy layer validity date which is mentioned on your certificate. So check it neatly and then enter the date of validity. Then select the admission quota, that is home university, admission scheme, from which admission scheme you have taken your admission. Then either you are belonging to any minority or not, that you have to mention. If you are belonging to any minority, then you have to mention the details of your minority. Then select are you orphan or not, yes or no, that you have to select. And if you are orphan, then select the orphan type. Then here social reservations are given, that is ex-serviceman, that is defense 1 category, active domicile defense candidate, that is defense 2 category, and active domicile defense and active nail defense candidate, that is defense 3. So if you are having a social reservation, then you have to select it and then click on save and continue. If you are not having any social reservation, then no need to select this checkbox. Next tab is your qualification details. So here in this qualification details, the options are given for the course level, that is SSC, HSC, diploma, CET. So if you are a first year student, then you have to enter the qualification details, that is your SSC, HSC and CET. If you are a student of direct second year, then you have to select three qualification details, that is SSC, HSC and diploma. So here you have to mention your course level, course name, result, status, either it is declared or not, board or university, and year of passing. And then you have to give the registration number, seat number, marks obtained, total marks, percentage and grade, whatever you have received in the examination. At the end, you have to upload the document of your SSC certificate. For HSC also you have to upload your HSC certificate, and for CET also you have to upload your CET certificate at the end. So option is given, that is choose file. So whatever the results you are uploading, that you have to upload the files that should be less than 100 MB, and the format for the file is given, that is JPG, JPEG and PDF files you can upload over here. Then click on save qualification details. So one qualification detail will get saved. After that you have to enter the second qualification detail, that is HSC. Again in the qualification detail you have to select again HSC. Now the SSC option is not there because you have filled all the details of SSC. So here again you have to select your course name, result, status, either it is declared or not declared,
board or university for HSC, year of passing, your seat number, it is mentioned on your mark sheet, you can check it. Then enter your obtained marks, total marks, percentage will be calculated automatically. If the grade is mentioned on your mark sheet, then you can select the grade. And if the grade is not mentioned on your mark sheet, then there is no need to select the grade. Here you can enter the class, that is first class, second class, distinction, and then you have to choose your file, that is your mark sheet. So this is the second one, qualification detail. Now third one is your CET for first year students. So here you have to select common entrance test, then click on CET result status, then year of passing, here you have to enter your CET application number, which is mentioned on your result also, that you have to enter over here. Then enter your seat number of CET. On your CET mark sheet, the marks are given in the percentage form. So here you have to enter the marks out of 100, and later on the percentage will be displayed automatically. Then you have to select the file of your CET mark sheet. Then save qualification details. So in this way, first year students have to enter three qualification details, SSC, HSC and CET, and for directly admitted students of second year have to enter the details, that is HSC, SSC and diploma mark sheet. After that, next tab is additional details. So here in case of additional details, you have to enter your Aadhaar number, PAN number, if you are having a passport then passport number, driving license number if you are having, family income, hostel accommodation if you are having a hostel accommodation, then you have to select yes or no accordingly. Enter your family income and then click on save and continue. Then next step is photo and signature. Here you have to select your photo file. The size of this file should be less than 100 KB. Simple JPG image you can upload. Signature image. And then click on save photo details. Then click on save and continue. Next step is admission details. So here you have to select your study mode, that is first year, bachelor of pharmacy, that is your course, then pattern, exam, that is first semester, and college. So from this list you have to select your college, in which college you have taken your admission, that name of that college you have to enter over here, then save and continue. Now here the list of documents will be displayed depending upon your category, that is either you are a general category students or you are in the category. Depending upon that, the list of documents will be displayed over here, and likewise the documents you have to upload in the format, that is PNG, JPG, JPEG and PDF files can be uploaded over here. So one by one file you have to upload over here. First one scorecard is your JEE main NEET scorecard. So if you are having a NEET scorecard, then upload it, and if you are having a CET scorecard, then you can upload the CET mark sheet over here. Second is your SSC mark sheet. So select it and upload. Then domicile or living certificate, that is nationality and domicile, you can upload over here. Then DT allotment letter, that you have to upload over here. Then school living certificate, Indian nationality, HSC. If you are having a caste certificate, then caste certificate, caste validity certificate, non-criminal certificate, all these documents are necessary to upload over here. One by one you have to upload it. After uploading all the documents, you have to click on save document details. Here the checkbox is given, that is I hereby confirm that I have read all the instructions carefully. You have to click in this checkbox and then click on submit profile. So in this way your profile will get submitted from your login. It will be approved from your institute, and after approval of your form from the institute login, then only you can see the option for your online payment of this enrollment process. So we will wait for the approval of this form from the institute login, and after that in the next video I will show you how you can do the online payment for this enrollment fees. So keep watching this channel. For any query you can ask me in the comment section. The link for this login page is given in the description box. You can check it. Thank you so much for watching this video.